Welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God with Salami Eneojo Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you today.
Hello, good morning, and thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor Enoch Adejare, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insight to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Friday, the 16th day of October 2020, and our topic for today is The Commandos, Part 2. Let us pray. Our Father in Heaven, we worship you. Thank you for this privilege of learning at your feet. We ask that you would come and speak to us one more time in the way that we would understand. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. You are welcome again. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Philippians chapter 1 verse 21. Philippians 1:21 says, "For to me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." Philippians 1:21. And our Bible reading for today is from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9, from verse 16 to 17. 1 Corinthians 9:16 to 17 reads, "For though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of. For necessity is laid upon me, yea, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel. For if I do this thing willingly, I have a reward. But if against my will, a dispensation of the gospel is committed unto me." God bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. In our memory verse, we see Paul saying, "For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." Meaning, if he must be alive, then he must do the work of he who has sent him. And if he be dead, then it is even better off, because he would be with his Savior and the love of his life. This is the statement of a man who has undying love for the Lord. Yesterday, we saw the part 1 of our topic, which was the Commandos part 1. And we saw that God is interested in training men. Soldiers that he will raise that will destroy the enemy. Men who are willing and ready to endure the training so that they will come out refined. Today we'll be seeing the second part and we'll be trusting God to teach us by his Spirit. We learn in our devotional today that God loves commandos, and the reason is because a lot of his work can be done through them. These are men who are passionate, who are desirous to see the kingdom of God come and his will being done. They are soldiers of Christ who are brutal against the devil. We learn that Christian commandos do not have to be monitored closely by their pastors to achieve their deliverables. These ones are more than willing, more than ready to do the work of their master. They are influenced by the hunger in their hearts, and they are always hungry for even more. In scripture, we see a couple of such kind of commandos. We see, for example, our brother Paul. He knew his assignment, and he was ready to spread the gospel around the world. He never relented in this. There were many times when he carried this out even in dangerous situations. Times when he knew his own life was at risk. He never deterred. Instead, he still fired on. He went about preaching the word. Today, our Father in the Lord is asking us, how many souls have you won in the last 6 months? What is your excuse? If missionaries who are in hostile environments still preach the gospel, even in the face of death, then you don't have an excuse not to preach the gospel to people around you. The Bible tells us to preach the word, to be instant in season and out of season. Meaning to say, our preaching must be continuous. It must not be dependent on particular circumstances. We take charge of any occasion we find ourselves. The scripture tells us also that this work requires haste. Our Father in the Lord goes on to tell us a story. He says, "Some time ago, I was invited to preach outside Nigeria. I was talking with my host when he told me of a man called Cobra, a cultist who was also very rich and well connected. This Mr. Cobra was indeed a terror in the land, so no one dared to confront him." He says, "The more he talked about Cobra, the more I wanted to preach to him. Eventually, I asked him to arrange for me to meet the man. My host was alarmed. He said, 'Sir, he could kill you if you dare talk about Jesus to him.' However, I insisted on him setting up the meeting. On the D-Day, I met with Cobra and said, "Sir, the Lord has sent me to tell you that your cup is full and he is about to bring judgment on you." Within minutes, Cobra was on his knees. In the end, not only did I come out alive, I did so with a new soul won for my Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. So the question that we have to answer today from our daddy is, will you run away at the slightest threat, or will you forge ahead to do whatever God asks you to do? That's a question we must answer. For many of us, that opportunity that we have to speak to that person may be the last of such that that individual may have. How about if God is bringing that man across your path so that he will have a chance to amend his ways before it is late for him? Will you deny that individual that opportunity just because you are timid, you are fearful? That man may never come to the knowledge of Christ because you were so timid to speak to him. May God grant us understanding and boldness to be true commandos for Christ in Jesus' name. In Joshua chapter 24 verse 15, Joshua said, "And if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." This was a man who knew what he wanted and he chose the way of the Lord. He was also sure about this for his family as well. Our Father in the Lord tells us today that as for he himself and his household, there would be commandos for Christ. I myself, speaking also by God's grace, would be a commando for Christ. What about you, my dear? Please do not be left out. Choose you this day whom you would serve and be a commando for. Quickly, we would bow our heads and pray. We would say, "Father, please help me to be a commando for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me the grace, the enablement, the desire, the strength to be a commando for you. I choose this day to serve in your army. I refuse to live a weak Christian life. I receive grace, boldness, strength to be able to wrought great and mighty things in righteousness. Let your word continually be in my mouth, and let you alone be glorified. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this opportunity to resubmit ourselves. Lord, today we make a decision for you. We ask that you would come and train us and make us become men who would do mighty things for you in the name of Jesus. To you alone be all the glory, all the praise. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining us today. We are really excited that you came. If you'd like to speak to someone or to be a part of our online community so you could get more updates like this, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11226. You can also feel free to share this with anyone so that it can bless them also. As you go out today, may you receive an enablement, the grace to be able to speak the word of God without fear in the name of Jesus. God bless you mightily. Have a great day ahead in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.